Shorten English Senior Second Paper Content Session Start. Speaking on the demand for medical department in the Legislative Assembly, an honorable member said, "Mr. Speaker, sir, in supporting the cut motion, I would like to make a few observations. Many honorable members have spoken about the delay in the supply of medicines to the various hospitals and rural dispensaries. This question has been agitating the public mind for a long time. It is a well-known fact that the central medical stores run by the Government of India are not very quick and prompt in supplying medicines. It is high time that our government moved the central government and took over the stores themselves. Otherwise, there will be no salvation. Further, even though provision is made by the government and local bodies for the purchase of medicines, most of them are not supplied by the medical stores. The intents are returned with the remark hereafter means that they are never to be supplied. That is the position. Then some of the old drugs are still being supplied to the hospitals and dispensaries. Now that medical science has advanced to a great extent, the stores must be introduced to stock more of modern drugs. Then with regard to hospitals, many of these are understaffed. Even in big headquarters hospitals, there is dearth of doctors. I submit that the government should think of posting only doctors with postgraduate degree as district medical officers when the present incumbent retires. We must also send the most of the doctors with just the MBBS degree for training abroad. In most hospitals, we have not got specialists. When the present incumbents retire, we will find it very difficult to replace them with a highly qualified and experienced men. So the government must look ahead and see that these people are trained as early as possible so that they may take the place of those who are likely to retire soon. As far as possible, the idea of giving special wards to the dean or the heads of medical institutions should be discouraged. It is not known why we should encourage this practice. That would mean that the administration side will suffer. So I am sure that the Honorable Minister will pay attention to the side of the question also. With regard to primary health centers, doctors are posted but medicines are not supplied. They do not have adequate housing facilities. All these things must be provided before medical officers are posted to these centers. With regard to water supply schemes, so far as urban areas are concerned, it is moving very slowly. Even though many new appointments have been made in the sanitary engineering branch, the work is not progressing satisfactorily. So many municipalities are suffering for want of good drinking water supply schemes. The same is the case in rural areas. The water supply position is bad and the government must come to the aid of the rural people by sinking more wells and giving more grants for sinking of these wells. This is a very important thing that the government should take into consideration. With regard to flu epidemic, I understand that all the medicines that are to be administered for the disease have gone underground. That is the rumor spreading in the city. Whatever it is, the government must think of putting up 2 or 3 vans for each district and give adequate medical aid to the people. Instead of thinking about mobile blacksmithy and carpentry vans, the government should think of providing mobile medical vans so that they may go to the aid of the rural population. sealed tenters are invited by the Sports Authority of India Training Center, Salem, from reputed caterers for providing catering service to 60 sports training residing at Mahatma Gandhi Stadium, Salem. Tender documents can be obtained from the above office on payment of Rs. 500 up to 5 p.m. on 20th October 2012. Earnest money deposit required is Rs. 5,000. Demand draft may be sent in favor of the officer in charge, Sports Authority of India, Salem. Filled up tenters should be submitted not later than 3 p.m. on 21st October. They will be opened at 4 p.m. on the same day in the presence of tenterers on their authorized representatives. Sporty Authority of India has the right to accept or reject any tender without giving any reason therefor. Draft tender notice to be issued by the officer in charge. Applications are invited for the post of Vice Principal, Rajkot Besant School, Varanasi. The school is affiliated to the Central Board of Secondary Education. The applicant must have a master's degree. He should have at least 10 years teaching experience. He should be between 40 and 50 years of age. Salary is negotiable between Rs. 20,000 and Rs. 25,000 per mensum. Free family accommodation on the campus will be provided. Free meals and free education of two children in the school will be provided. There will be also the usual benefits of provident fund, gratuity, etc. All applications should reach the manager, Rajkot Besant School, Varanasi, on or before 10th October 2012. Draft advertisement. Draft a letter to the editor of the Hindu, Chennai, on the following lines. There are stands for auto rickshaws. In the same way, there should be facilities for call taxis. It is found that many of these call taxis are parked. For hours together near resistance. The driver should avoid parking their vehicles in such places, as it possesses a great danger to the resistance. It is not known who or what is inside the vehicles. The authorities concerned should hear